We live on a tiny blue planet floating through space, and the universe is a mean place. We aren't as safe as you think. The universe isn't always kind to life. There are countless ways in which the Earth could be destroyed tomorrow, and some are more likely than others. And I'm not talking about the obvious stuff, like asteroids hitting the Earth. So let me show you four of the most terrifying ways that the Earth could be destroyed literally tomorrow. And you need to be prepared, because when I learned about the last one, I genuinely lost sleep for weeks. In the depths of the cosmos exists an object that even Einstein didn't believe existed in reality. It wanders the galaxy all alone, and if it comes near our little blue planet, it wouldn't even have to touch us to end all life on Earth for eternity. The worst part is, it's invisible. And it's not alone. It's estimated that there might be 500 million of these terrifying objects wandering our galaxy alone, and trillions more throughout the observable universe. I'm talking about rogue black holes. These are black holes that are born when massive stars reach the end of its life. The core collapses and leaves behind a black hole. This black hole will then wander the cosmos, invisible to the naked eye. There's a few methods that we can use to detect them, all of which rely on looking at how the black hole interacts with its environment. Sometimes we find them sucking matter off another star, and sometimes we see the star being whipped around the black hole by its intense gravity. Other times we actually can just find them by looking at how their gravity distorts the light behind them. This distortion effect is known as gravitational lensing. Stellar mass black holes that wander the galaxy all alone are much, much smaller than you might think. Stars like the Sun are more than 1 million kilometers wide, and giant stars like Betelgeuse can be even larger than that, more than 1 billion kilometers wide. That's as large as Jupiter's orbit around the Sun. But because black holes are the densest objects in the known universe, a black hole with a mass equal to our Sun would be just 6 kilometers wide. This makes this kind of black hole nearly impossible to detect. The closest black hole that we found is Gaia BH1, a terrifying black hole that's around 1,560 light years away. And I'm sure you're like, oh, well, that's fine. I mean, there's stars that are like 4 light years away, and we aren't worried that any of them are gonna come crashing into us anytime soon. And I hear you, but get this. We have only found a few dozen of these black holes ever, and we think there's 500 million of them around us. Assuming they are evenly distributed throughout the galaxy, there should be one within around 50 light years of the Earth. Now, I'm sure you don't feel quite as safe, do you? If a rogue black hole did happen to enter our solar system, things would get scary quick. We would only really be able to detect the black holes by seeing the distortion of space-time around the black hole's event horizon as it journeys towards us. There are three ways that the black hole could destroy life on Earth in this scenario. The most obvious would of course be the black hole swallowing the Earth whole. If the black hole made direct contact with Earth, it would quickly tear us apart and consume the planet. This is the most unlikely scenario. The chances of it happening in our galaxy are about 1 in 1 billion. Another way to destroy the Earth would be if the black hole tidally disrupts our planet. This is where the black hole passes close enough to us such that the gravitational pull on the close side of the Earth is much stronger than the far side. This would lead to the planet being ripped apart and would transform the Earth into a stretched out stream of debris that looks like a piece of spaghetti, earning this process the scientific name, spaghettification. The chances of this happening would be about 1 in 10 million. These odds are still small, but not that small. It's more likely than you winning the jackpot on a Powerball lottery ticket. And finally, life on Earth could be completely destroyed, even if the black hole comes nowhere near us. If it simply passed through somewhere in the vicinity of the solar system, it could disturb the orbits of all of the planets, causing Earth to be sent flying out of the solar system, or even into the Sun. This option is by far the most likely. There is a 1 in 10,000 chance that a black hole passes within the orbit of Jupiter over the course of the solar system's history. If we do one day discover that a black hole is on a collision course with the Earth, I personally hope that they keep it from us, because frankly, there's nothing we could do. We would just have to accept our fate. 150 million kilometers away from the Earth is our biggest friend and perhaps biggest enemy. The sun gives Earth life, but it can just as easily take it away. Roughly every 11 years, the sun goes through a cycle of getting progressively more active before calming down for a few years. And the terrifying part is, we have literally just entered into the next solar maximum just a few weeks ago. I've spoken on this channel before about how in a few billion years, the sun will run out of fuel and expand into a red supergiant consuming the Earth. But this is not the danger I'm talking about. I'm talking about solar storms. Solar flares and coronal mass ejections are events that essentially consist of really quickly moving charged particles being ejected from the sun and shot out into space. There is constantly a stream of these particles being shot out of the sun, and this forms what we call solar wind. But these focused events can be extremely dangerous if they are aimed at the Earth. Perhaps the best example of this is back in 1859. An astronomer named Richard Carrington was tracking a really massive sunspot when all of a sudden he saw a massive white flash of light. This blinding white light flare lasted for a total of 5 minutes, and just 18 hours later, havoc ensued here on Earth. Aurora was seen all around the globe, and mining workers were awoken during the night because they thought that it was daytime. It was just so bright outside due to the aurora. Telegraph systems even caught fire despite being entirely disconnected. This would forever go on to be known as the Carrington Event, the strongest geomagnetic storm in recorded history. If something like that happened today, it would likely cause millions of people to die and many, many trillions of dollars worth of damage. The reason these storms are so dangerous comes down to how they actually form within the sun. When we look at the sun using our modern technology, we can see these loops, tendrils, and streams of hot ionized plasma. Plasma is just atoms that have been cooked to be so hot that they lost all of their electrons, just leaving the atomic nuclei behind. And all of these explosive features are caused by the sun's magnetic field. The hot charged particles get caught in the magnetic field that's generated within the sun's surface, causing them to travel on these massive arches. We are literally seeing the magnetic field with our own eyes right there. These magnetic field lines enter and exit the surface of the sun super randomly, and because they are so strong, we often see them loop back, split apart, and then reconnect. When this happens, the particles get accelerated really, really quickly and kind of shot out of the sun like a slingshot, traveling through the vacuum of space at up to 9 million kilometers per hour. That's fast enough to go from New York to Tokyo in just 5 seconds. We will surely have to face one of these events sometime this century, and when we do, it will get ugly. The storm would be detected and then arrive at the Earth within 24 hours, meaning we would have just 1 day to shut the entire world's power grid off in preparation. The charged particles would rain down on Earth, pushing through our magnetosphere and reshaping our own magnetic field. Granted, the aurora would be stunning, but that's where the fun stops. Currents of electricity would be induced in the power grids, causing surges of power that result in power stations and transformers exploding. All of the communications infrastructure would be completely offline, so these fires would just continue to burn uncontrolled. Nearly everyone in the Western world would likely be without power for weeks, months, or even much, much longer, and those in underdeveloped countries would likely suffer for years. Millions worldwide would freeze, starve, or die of dehydration. And I know all of this sounds terrifying, but the worst part is, this is honestly the least scary way Earth could be destroyed that's being covered in this video. So take a deep breath, because things are about to get crazy. Have you ever noticed that every few months, it feels like there's a news headline saying an asteroid is about to hit the Earth, or aliens have finally visited us? When it comes to space, the media is known to sensationalize science. The best tool I've found to help me consume news in a more transparent way is Ground News, the sponsor of today's video. Founded by former NASA engineer Harleen Kuhl, who worked on the James Webb Space Telescope and New Horizons mission, Ground News gathers articles from all around the world in one place, showing you how different sources cover the same story to provide you with context behind the source's bias, factuality, and who owns the source. For example, let's look at this story about those two NASA astronauts stuck on the ISS. we can see that Story has been covered by over 300 outlets. Looking at the bias distribution chart, most of the coverage is coming from center-leaning sources. We can also see that 72% of the articles are ranked as highly factual based on three independent monitoring organizations. For stories like this, with far-reaching coverage, we can use the headline comparison tool. For example, this right-leaning source paints Elon Musk as a hero, while this left-leaning source more directly reports on the mission. In this way, we can see how different outlets frame the same story. So if you care about space, science, or just seeing through the noise, Ground News is a serious game changer. Give it a try by signing up through my link at groundnews.com/AstroKobi, where you'll get 50% off their Vantage plan, which is what I use to get unlimited access to all of the features. I genuinely believe that Ground News is doing important work, so I do hope that you'll check their services out. This next terrifying way that the Earth could be destroyed was actually discovered by complete accident. In 1963, during the height of the Cold War, the UK, US, and Soviet Union all came together and agreed that they would not detonate nukes in the atmosphere or out in space. But this was just everyone agreeing to not do something. I mean, how could they really trust each other? And so, the US, doing what the US does, decides to launch a bunch of satellites named Vela to monitor and see if the Soviets were being honest. These satellites were mostly just looking for X-rays and gamma radiation. These are markers that would be released if a nuke was detonated in the atmosphere. They never found any signs of nuclear testing. But one day, both of the satellites had a huge spike of gamma radiation. Weirdly, it didn't appear to be coming from the Earth, and scientists had no idea what caused the spike. So they waited, and it happened again. And then again, and again, until by 1973, they had found 16 of these gamma ray bursts. It would take a further 20 years for us to finally solve the mystery of these gamma ray bursts. We know now that these flashes of gamma rays were being caused by either two neutron stars merging together, or by core collapse supernovae, like the black hole formation that we were just talking about. When a massive star runs out of its nuclear fuel, the core collapses. In this process, a gamma ray burst is created. As the star collapses, a black hole is formed, and very strong magnetic fields keep some of the star's material from falling straight into the black hole. This magnetic field guides material to the poles of the star, where it is then shot out into space at nearly the speed of light. Like a cosmic death beacon, anything in the way of these beams of hot plasma is in danger. The beam is comprised of this stellar plasma, gamma rays, electrons, and positrons, and it's seriously deadly. In less than a second, these GRBs produce as much energy as the sun will emit over the course of 10 billion years. They are so powerful that we can detect them from billions of light years away. These extremely distant GRBs from other galaxies are still powerful enough to disrupt our radio communications here on Earth. Any gamma ray burst within a 200 light year radius that makes a direct hit with the Earth will vaporize our planet. The atmosphere would be ionized and harmful radiation would rain down on all of Earth's creatures. It would be a slow and painful death. And what's worse, it has happened before. 440 million years ago, the Earth underwent the second largest mass extinction event in history, second to, of course, the dinosaur-killing asteroid. 85% of all species on Earth went extinct. It is believed that a hypernova event occurred around 6,000 light years away from Earth. If the gamma ray burst lasted just 10 seconds, Earth's atmosphere would have been stripped of half of its ozone nearly immediately. This exposed all of the animals on Earth to high levels of UV radiation. And the researchers leading this theory have estimated that an event like this should occur at least once every billion years or so. The chances are, of course, low, but not zero. And realistically, there's nothing we could do to save the Earth. So whether it happens a billion years from now or literally tomorrow, I'm sure whoever's around then will not be having a good day. This final method for how the Earth could be destroyed tomorrow is the most horrifying, because it wouldn't just destroy the Earth, it would destroy the entire universe instantly. I'm serious. What I'm talking about is known as false vacuum decay, and people often make it sound really complicated when I think anyone can understand it. First, I want you to think about energy levels. I mean, everything has an energy level. Think of these like the increasing levels on a stovetop. Level 1 is of course the lowest level, while level 9 is the highest. The higher the energy level, the more energy. In physics classes, we are most often taught about this in the context of electron energy levels, because they can only occupy distinct, specific energy levels. And the fact that we hear repeated all the time is that everything is more stable in its ground state. This is the lowest energy level. Every system in our universe follows this rule, and that is the key to destroying the universe. And here's where things typically get confusing, because we're about to delve into quantum field theory. But stick with me. Quantum field theory just tells us that all of the elementary particles that make up the universe, the quarks, leptons, and bosons, they are all created by quantum fields that are present all throughout the universe. These fields tell all the particles how they can interact with one another, essentially giving us the laws of the universe. And these quantum fields, just like the electron, also want to be in their lowest ground stable state. Let's call it a vacuum state. Physicists are convinced that all of the fields associated with all the particles of the universe are in their vacuum states, all of them except for one. The Higgs field, associated with the famous Higgs boson, is what gives all particles in the universe their mass. And since how massive an object is relates to how much gravity it possesses, the Higgs field is really important. If the Higgs field is not actually in its vacuum state right now, things get scary. Imagine a ball that rolls down a hill and rests in a nice little valley. It appears to be stable. This is the Higgs field ball, and from the outside, it seems like it has achieved its vacuum state, but it hasn't. It can keep going down even lower to a more stable state. And if this happened, if a section of the Higgs field somewhere out there in the universe achieved its true vacuum state through quantum tunneling, this would set off a chain reaction. The real vacuum state of the Higgs field would spread throughout the universe like a wildfire, converting the rest of the field as it grows. It would travel throughout the universe at the speed of light. Everything this expanding, true vacuum state touches will simply be annihilated from existence. It will grow like this until the entire observable universe is, well, gone. The Earth would disappear instantly, and all of the laws governing the universe would likely change. Maybe life could form again, but we really would just have no idea what the universe would even look like. Ultimately, we don't really know if vacuum decay is real or not. Our current accepted models of physics suggest that it could be, but it's not like we have observed it or anything like that. And even if it does turn out to be true, it's not like there's anything we could really do to stop it. So try not lose sleep over it. I know I have.